I should be focusing on, like, combat-oriented stuff and not necessarily mobility for this tank, because it's actually fairly mobile. $27,500.
Finish up my toast real quick. Be right back.
Yeah, okay.
Did you go north or south? You went south. Okay.
I muted myself because I sneezed. Because I was going to say that, hold on. Well, I was going A. Oh, what a fucking troll.
I really hope that they give us bigger maps.
I mean, a lot of the new maps are actually fairly decent, but yes, they do need even bigger maps, because these maps are really not big enough for modern aircraft.
Yeah.
I mean, it's very constraining even now for the jets that we do have.
I just mean, like, in general, you know, tanks are getting better, like, you know, aircraft are getting faster.
I mean, for tanks, some of the larger size maps are really big enough. Because I would like to point out that I don't know if anything else is up in here. Come on, reload, reload. I need some assistance, cause my main gun breach is out and I'm about to lose my coax.
You got a firefly and me coming up the hill right now.
Too late. Yeah, see that the PT-76 came in and with his heat round just took out my entire turret and my gun breach. And then I shot him with the 37mm and apparently only got his commander. My armor-piercing, high-explosive 37mm round did not one-shot the PT-76. Remember to try and stay in a hull-down position and use the hill crest to your advantage.
Now I got people shooting me from the flank, too.
I'm going to try and find them.
Oh, like, over there.
Because things are rendering in really fucking weird. I just got shot at from the response. Is that a VFW? Oh! Please let it be a VFW. I like killing those things super hard. Oh, there's the PT-76 dead.
That's how I played the PT-76.
It is the VFW. To be careful, because...
That's my range. 800, roughly.
Thank you!
Oh, that's not what I want to fuck with.
What are you shooting at? I still can't find it.
It's back on top of their fucking ridge line by their spawn. By their south spawn.
But, oh, I see it.
There's two tanks. There's,
Well, one of them died. And, oh, that's a tiger.
One of them looked like almost,
Anyway.
IS of some sort, T-85.
I think it was a T-34-85, because it died.
Yeah.
And that's also what killed you.
What killed me was in A.
Oh, there's another T-30 now. Okay, there's a T-30-85 there, and then there was a Tiger. Oh, I think something open top just spawned. Oh, I think it's that the Chinese AA. Or, no, that's a KV-2. And he's still got spawn protection. But that's not going to apparently stop her M4A3 from pushing in. Ooh. That's a lot of fire coming from the ground.
Yeah, there's a anti-air. He did.
I have yet to spawn any planes.
Don't say that.
Why?
I don't be good at dogfights.
Well, then go fly back and get more bombs.
I'm working on that, actually, as we speak. I did want to kill that fucking anti-air, though. Before I did.
Oh, there's a plane.
See?
Yeah, but I do want a dogfight. It's the only thing Japanese planes are good at. They don't really have a very good ground attack. And in ground battles, people are really stupid and want to try and turn fight you, which I'm sorry, I'm just gonna win, unless you're a Spitfire. What is this?
Oh wow, okay. Landing. It works. Fucked up my prop, fucked up my wing, fucked up my landing gear, fucked everything up, but I got the repair count down. That's all.
Oh god, I can't see this dude anymore.
He is somewhere above you. He's going for like a stall climb.
He already tried that, and then...
There is a second airplane up too, by the way. Didn't award you with the kill.
Yeah, oh well.
Actually, against an IL too. Things are pretty fun. I don't know if you've tried it.
Oh, the IL too? Yes. They're my favorite Russian plane. I was kind of excited they added the SU-7, but I'm not in a position to actually research it. Nor, and I kind of lost all interest in Russian planes because they didn't have any attackers. For a small time, I was thinking of buying, because they did have the ground attack version of one of the MiGs. I think it was the MiG-15, and I thought about buying that one, but they no longer offer it, and I'm not buying the Cuban MiG-17 because fuck that thing. Of course, fuck MiGs in general, they're kind of pieces of shit. And that they're just utter bullshit.
Ooh, there's a tank. Oh, that overshot. Why?
Should we just for your moms?
That was the KV-2. Give me a fucking assist. I spotted him for you. Oh, there is a plane above me. That is not good.
Wow, I mean, we have two planes up. Flurry, we have three planes up, so are you sure it wasn't one of ours?
No, I looked back and saw him. He's fighting the P-59.
See if I can help this M24 out. Fighting whatever this is that he's fighting. There's a triple A up and he's shooting, but I can't actually see him.
Breaks.
Oh, now I see him. Driver, commander, gunner. Eye for an eye. Oh, that piece of shit. That's the one Italian vehicle I will refuse to unlock. Until I'm actually using the other Fiat vehicles.
I think it's actually a semi-decent AA. I enjoy it.
If it has no place in a 3-point, like at the BR that it's at. I have no clue what. Oh shit, that is a jumbo.
I mean, it's not as good as it used to be after they took away the Panzer Grenade 40.
I don't care, like, go ahead and give it that ammo, just put it at 6.0. Like, Italy already has a decent enough AA for World War II. They don't need something that low, because they have something that can fill that spot. I like how our team is completely ignoring, like, they're all pushing into, like, one spawn, or into both spawns, including the fact that's not where the enemy is. I mean, there shouldn't be, unless it's the American one.
Yeah, it's the 59. Trying to build my speed and energy back up. Something coming out of A.
Oh well, best squad.
Da da da. Horizontal drive, yes. Compressor, yes. Give me H-bars. I love H-bars.
Target 23,299 to go. I need to go in this chat bots.
A chat bot?
Yeah, I need to get a chat bot. Someone to welcome the guests. To tell people to like and subscribe. Oh, I didn't ready up. Now I'm ready.
Oh, I'm gonna slap some fucking HVARs on this shit. Have fun.
I think the Tech 93 is kinda cool. But I don't know if it necessarily replaces the Type 87.
I don't know. I like the Type 87 more. Like, Type 93 is cool, but...
Simply because of the... I don't know.
I really think it does need, like, something. Like, it needs a 7.62 machine gun or something.
See, the problem is... is now we're getting into an area of combat with combined arms and all that kind of stuff that just... I don't know.
Like,
from a person who's...
to do its own job.
Who has played wargaming stuff before and realizing that a lot of these short-range missiles are being used for something that's not necessarily their intended purpose...
Yeah.
Because really, when the United States wants to shoot down incoming aircraft, they just launch Patriots. I mean, that's what the Patriots for. It's like shooting down helicopters and close range things is when you start like throwing Stingers and mostly Stingers is when you start throwing Stingers. That's what. So that infantry can defend themselves against, like, helicopters. And that's why, I think, I don't know if I talked to you about this, but there is, like, a lot of people, I'm just going to customize this. There's a lot of people who complain about the British one, the HVM.
Okay.
Because it has such a terrible time in game shooting down aircraft. Because you have to get a... because I mean, part of that is, yes, the missile is not... And some of that, I think, has to do with latency. And so the server isn't necessarily handling it properly. But others is just the fact that you have to get direct hits. Like, you have to. Because it's impact fuse only... They're micro munitions. They do blow up. They're not. You're not lobbing APDS darts at it. It hits and then it explodes. Oh, hello. Where's that from? But, like the HVM system, the stars. I think they're Star Streak, which. I have no clue where I just got shot from.
I'm trying to get up there.
I think it was from behind. I think there's a bunch of bushes in my way. I think this wrecked building...
There's something to my 12.
I mean, I don't have an engine. Oh my god. Yeah, he shot me through that. Because he's just in the... He's surrounded by teammates.
I'm about to be putting in some fucking work over here.
Anyway, But the Starstreak missiles are man portable. They're man pads. You know, man portable air defense.
I don't know what the fuck I just killed.
An AMX-13 prototype vehicle thing. Which really isn't necessary if they would just give France armored cars. Oh, they have. They started to. They're giving them some. Which, by the way, you can thank me for the, shit. I'm trying to remember. It's not the ERC-90. Or is it the ERC-90?
Oh, there's like a thicker max or something over there.
But anyway, it's meant to shoot down helicopters, the point I'm trying to make. Like, the Starstreak missile was designed to shoot down helicopters. It is the British close... Even though I don't know, I don't think Britain has a long-range missile. Like, you know, America has Patriots.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think England does. England might just use Patriots also. Where's the dude that killed that dude? That was something kind of interesting.
Oh god! Oh, almost flipped on my side! Oh, he is salty! That was an attempted revenge kill.
But even in real life, the Starstreak missile has, and the Stormer HVM, has trouble shooting down planes. And I can't remember what the... Because Britain also has another surface-to-air missile that they use that's more like the conventional ones that, you know, has proximity fuse, the missile goes close, blows up, and then knocks your plane out of the sky. Which is used to shoot down... Oh! Oh, whoa!
There's someone over there.
So some AAA was shooting at me, and then this dickwad drops two tiny little bombs. I'm gonna look this up. British surface-to-air missiles. The Rapier, that's what it is. The Rapier. Which they could have given us the tracked Rapier system. I mean, it's huge, but it would have the radar. It'd be a mobile vehicle, have radar, and have missiles to be able to, you know, shoot down planes. I hate when 20 millimeters hit, but then they don't seem to do anything. Unless they're British. That Whirlwind just shrek that dude.
Dude, I put in some fucking work this match.
But the point is to shoot helicopters down. And I like to point out that a lot of the pilots complain about the surface air missiles, like the plane pilots. And the truth is, like, we didn't need them. Because that's also what the Gepard's for. That's what the M247 is for. Like, those were not developed to shoot down, like, airplanes. Like, that is not why companies started developing or redeveloping self-propelled anti-air guns. It was because of the helicopters. Because there was this whole problem where helicopters, you know, can just hover behind something and then pop up and then attack you with an ATGM, right? Kill you and then pop back behind cover. right?
Yep.
And surface, like Patriot missiles cannot deal with that. And, like, all this other stuff cannot deal with that. Like, you're gonna need something that has radar and quick... Oh, no. No!
Wow.
That did not kill me. Those were right next to me. And those
There's
did not kill me.
Coming in from 20.
20.
Yeah, it's heading 20.
Oh, I see it.
Luckily.
That's really far away. Like, the Gepard and all them are... And, like, even though we already had the M163, right? The M163, the 20mm, the Vulcan was not sufficient enough and didn't have range enough to deal with that. The 35mm did. The 40mm were going to deal with... I mean, to a degree, there is, like, low-flying attack aircraft they'd be able to deal with, but that's also why we have now the M6 Linebacker, which is a Bradley that, instead of having tow missiles... has stingers, and I think that would have been more acceptable than the thing that they gave the Americans now, that only Canada I hit his tail, that only Canada actually accepted into service. I mean, it's fine. I mean, the M247 wasn't in there either, and it's kind of...
I do hope that, you know, since we have vehicles like the Centurion, Centura, whatever the fuck it is, that we get the anti-tank strikers.
So, you mean the one that has the tow missiles on it?
No, the one with the 105.
Oh, you mean the ground support one?
Yeah.
Because that is not that is not a tank destroyer.
Oh, whatever. It looks full of shit.
In fact, the M16, or not the M16, the Type 16 or whatever, the Japanese one, is also not a tank destroyer.
I do not care. I will use it as such.
Let's just label it. Same thing with the AMX-10 RC. Destroyer of vehicles. Eye for an eye, that's the guy who killed me. Yeah, hey, fuck that dude. It is not a tank destroyer, it is the French light tank. It replaced the AMX-13 as France's light tank. It is a wheeled light tank.
As such, I will use a 105 and put it in work. Because that would be actually a very capable vehicle.
You say that.
I think it has an autoloader. I'm fairly certain.
Basically, they took the gun from the M60 tank. Oh shit. I was not paying attention. Because I got messaged by someone.
Uh-huh.
Wait, is that the guy I killed in the two... Hold on. No. Yes. Oh, I don't need these bombs. Basically, they took the same gun from the M60 and they fixed an autoloader to it because they didn't want to actually put a actual turret.
I thought they could fit. 120 was way too much.
No, they just didn't want to put, like, a turret on it. So that's why it has that tiny little thing.
Mm-hmm.
And has an autoloader, so you don't have to...
Well, the suspension...
Because the turret would